was a revelation from Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show his servants the events that must soon take place. He sent an angel to present this revelation to his servant John, who faithfully reported everything he saw. This is his report of the Word of God and the testimony of Jesus Christ. Good morning. Thanks for joining me for Hosanna. And we're in Revelation chapter 1. God blesses the one who reads the words of this prophecy to the church. He blesses all who listens to its message and obeys what it says, for the time is near. This letter is from John to the seven churches in the province of Asia. Grace and peace to you from the one who is, who always was, and who is to come, from the sevenfold Spirit before his throne, and from Jesus Christ. He is the faithful witness to these things, the first to rise from the dead, and the ruler of all the kings of the world. In the book of Revelations, there are 37 different titles and names for the Lord Jesus Christ. And I believe as we study these names and titles, it'll deepen our walk with Christ and draw us closer to him. All glory to him who loves us and has freed us from our sin by the shedding of his blood. He has made us a kingdom of priests. Isn't that glorious? For God his Father, all glory and power to him forever and ever. Look, he comes with the clouds of heaven, and everyone will see him, even those who pierced him. All the nations of the world will mourn for him. Amen. I am the Alpha and Omega. I am the beginning and the end, saith the Lord. I am the one who is, who always was, and who is still to come, the Almighty One. Jesus is the Alpha and the Omega, the A to the Z, the beginning and the end. We have in the four Gospels the public ministry of the Lord Jesus Christ. 3 years of his earthly ministry of teaching, signs, wonders, and miracles. But you see, Jesus is the living Word of God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Jesus is and was and will always be. When we read through the Bible, we discover Christ in the story of creation. You'll find Jesus in Genesis chapter 1. And as you read through the Bible, you'll remember stories like found in the book of Daniel. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were thrust into the fiery furnace. But there was a fourth, and that's right. It was the Son of the Living God. It was the Lord Jesus Christ himself. And what about when Jesus is resurrected from the dead and ascends to be with the Father? The Bible tells us in the book of Acts, we see Paul on the road to Damascus. And who will greet Paul? That's right. He sees a vision. He sees the Lord Jesus Christ himself. Oh, remember today that Jesus is the Alpha and Omega, from Genesis to Revelation, from the beginning to the end. Jesus was, Jesus is, and will always be. Father God, on this glorious Monday morning, we start another week and we give you glory and we give you praise. Bless this day, we pray, as we serve our risen Savior, the King of Kings. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God loves you, so do I. You be blessed today. It's cold and it's windy. It's about to rain, and I'm up in the hills, walking and hiking and praying and thinking about Revelation chapter 1. You pray and ponder who Jesus is today. He is the Alpha and Omega. You be blessed today. Be safe. Let God's grace go before you, and let His peace fill your heart.